सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतो वंदे भगवन्तो पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनि सक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा वृषाभिः शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणो जाति पुरो येदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तरुणहतीमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुवै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः कामनायान्ते संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे So we began the Dvitiya Pada of the Antima Adhyaya and we looked at the first Adhikarana is Vagha Adhikarana. So Vagha Adhikarana. Now, what is the Gati or is there any Gati? This is the discussion that is going to come up with a comparison in the background of a dying person versus an upasaka and or jnani. So vang manasi darshana chabda cha, vang manasi darshana chabda cha. Bhagavan Sutrakara says vak manasi darshanat shabdat cha. There is a shruti vakya vang manasi sampadyate. So we see this in Chandogya 6th chapter, the krama of the laya of all the indriyas ityadi are discussed there. Now this is true for a dying person as well as the jnani. So vak manasi sampadyate kutaha, what is a hetu? Meaning the mind resolve, the speech resolves in the mind. This is a statement made there. Why? Because Shruti is there, Darshanat, Shabdachya. So Darshanat, Shabdachya. Because of the Shruti itself saying so, that is Darshana. Sorry. And there is also, so Shabda and Darshana. Darshana and Shabda both can mean Shruti. Darshana, since Shabda is there, Shabda should be taken as Shruti. And Darshana can be, since it is seen so. It is seen so, where in the world also you see such a thing as possibility. So that can be the, because it is observed. So plain observation can be taken by darshana, and shabda means the scriptural shruti vakya. Chandogya already quoted, so vang manasi sampadyate, that is going to come up in the vritti also. So in one section there, Acharya explains the Shishya Shweta Ketu, the son as well, how the Krama is in the Laya. Generally, as a general rule, however, is the Srishti, opposite is the Laya. This is but logical. We had seen this similarity in an example given as to how a person climbs a ladder. The opposite is the Krama in climbing down. That was stated by the Siddhanti. So here also vak manasi sampadyate darshanat shabdachya, because of observation in the world. As to how do you observe it in the world, you see by anubhava. Your own anubhava is also like that, and you can see from the way others also, their mind is active but they stop speaking. Or in meditation also, you, even if you don't speak, what happens to the vritti? You hear the sound within. You are not speaking, but there are thoughts regarding speech also. Not seeing this or tasting that, but about speech itself. You want to say something, but you bite your tongue. So that time, what happens to that vritti? Vak vritti results in the mind. So that kind of understanding can be brought about by darshanat and shabdash, since Shruti also says so. Now this is a layakrama in during death. So what example in darshana we saw, this is not during death, this is the death of the speech, meaning you do not speak, you let the speech die, as so to say. So it is not a moment of death though, but it is the death of the speech, so to say, figuratively. So with that example, you can extend it towards the end of life also. Somebody stops speaking and then slowly the indriyas withdraw. पादांतरत्वाद अस्य अधिकरणस्य न अव्यवहित अधिकरण संगत्यपेक्षा. सिंस अ न्यू पादा हैज बीन स्टार्टेड बाय द सूत्रकार, देयर फोर देर इज नो संगति अक्रॉस पादास नीडेड अक्रॉस अधिकरण ऑल्सो, सिंस देर इज अ क्रॉस ओवर इंटू न्यू पादा. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे सोपादानि स्वस्य लय इति न्याय असिद्धि सिद्धांते तत्सिद्धिरिति फलभेदः. सो पूर्वपक्षी सॉरी पूर्व पक्षी आस वेदर द लया इज इन टू इट्स ओन उपादना और नॉट. जनरली द न्याय इज वॉट, न्याय इज दैट इन वंस ओन मटीरियल कॉज इज द लया ऑफ द कार्य. सो द उपादान कारण इज वॉट इन टू विच द कार्य विल रिजॉल्व. Now this vak and manah, between vak and manah, what is the sambandha? Manas. There is no karya karana bhava at all. Vak is not the karya of manas. So sopadane swasya layah iti nyaya asiddhi. That nyaya itself he is not agreeing with, because agni aumsha karya is vak and sattva aumsha karya is manas. मीनिंग अग्नि वन्नी इन द पंच महाभूत, वी विल हैव सीन दिस इन तत्वबोध. सो हाउ द क्रिएशन स्टोरी अनफोल्ड्स, इन दैट हाउ द इंद्रियाज आर क्रिएटेड, वी सी दैट द सत्वांश ऑफ द वन्नी अग्नि बिकम्स द वागेन्द्रिय. सो सच एटलीस्ट इन सम प्रक्रिया इट विल बी सीन इन दिस मैनर. सो जनरली इन आई थिंक छांदोग्य सिक्स चैप्टर, इन छांदोग्य सिक्स चैप्टर ऑल्सो अन्न 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 दैट इज ईटन द सूक्ष्म अंश ऑफ दैट विल बिकम मनस. Thereby there are various differences between a general prakriya known and a specific prakriya in Chandogya. Considering both, also Purvapakshi says that there is no karya resolving into its own upadana. So that nyaya is asiddha as per the nyaya asiddhi as per the पूर्व पक्षी सिद्धांत तत्सिद्धिरिति फलभेद. इन सिद्धांत सेज नो देर इज सच ऑब्जर्वेशन इन द वर्ल्ड एज वेल एज देर इज अ श्रुति विच इज द सूत्रार्थ, देर फोर फलभेद इज सच बिटवीन पूर्व पक्षी एंड सिद्धांत. अस्ति उत्क्रांति क्रम बोधिका श्रुति अस्य सौम्य पुरुषस्य प्रयतो वांग मनसि संपद्यते मनः प्राणे प्राणस्तेजसि तेजस तेज परस्याम देवतायाम. सो दिस इज द छांदोग्य श्रुति. The laya krama is mentioned as to he somya asya purushasya. The indriyas of this purusha, which purusha prayataha, one who is dying, what happens to him? Vak manasi sampadyate. The mind, the speech attends the mind. So vagendriya attends the mind, means resolves into the mind. Manaha prane, mind into the prana. Pranaha tejasi. So prana resolves into tejas, meaning agni, and tejaha parasyam devatayam, finally into parabrahma. Iti. This is what we see in the layakrama. In the shashtavadhyaya, the eighth kanda of Chandogya Upanishad. Tatra vang manasi sampadyate ityatra kim savrittikaya vachayo manasi laya kim va vagvrittehe iti samshaye shruti balat vacha eva iti purva paksha. Now, The question is whether the indriya complete resolves into its karana or only the vritti. So swavritti kaya vachaha. Vak along with its vrittis, does it resolve into manas or the vagendriya is still there but the vritti resolves. So vag vritti hi eva manasi layaha. That is one option, the second option here. The first option is what? Swavritti kaha vachaha manasi layaha. So the vagindriya along with its vrittis resolves into the mind completely. That is the first option. Second option is just the vrittis. Vagindriya is still there. Shruti balad vacha eva iti purvapaksha. Meaning the vagindriya resolves along with its vritti, says the purvapakshi. So you can see two different purvapaksha. Sopadane swasya laya iti nyaya asiddhi. Because what is he saying? You have to find a karyakarana bhava. If you find a karyakarana bhava, then laya will be there. Now you can mix the purvapaksha. Which is the karya for what here? Meaning vak and manas, there is no karyakarana bhava. So the laukika nyaya is vak should resolve into the mind. The laukika nyaya does not allow vak to resolve in the mind. So nyaya asiddhi, meaning although manas is not the karana of vak, still the vak resolves into the mind completely. Indriya resolves into the antakkarana. This is the claim made by the purvapakshi. And that is what is meant by sopadane swasya laya iti nyayasya asiddhi. Otherwise, what should happen? Otherwise, vak should resolve into its own karana, which is agni. And manas should resolve into its own karana, which is actually sattvamsha of all mahabhutas. The mind is created from sattvamsha of all mahabhutas put together. That is why manas is karana for every indriya to work. Without manas, no indriya can work. And each indriya is grasping indriya is grasping the dharma or the guna of each mahabhuta, not the other. But antakkarana mind, it grasps the guna of all the, it assists in grasping the gunas of all mahabhutas. Therefore, manas, which is the karya of sattvamsha of all mahabhutas put together, should resolve into its own karana. So manaha prane, prana is not the cause for manas, it is not the upadana karana. Therefore this krama is still valid, says the purvapakshi. Why? Complete resolution is possible because Shruti says so, and he does not agree with the laukika nyaya that karya should resolve only into its karana. So this is the purvapaksha when you put them together, these statements in the vritti. Otherwise, sopadane swasya laya iti nyayasya asiddhi cannot be seen to connect with the Purvapakshi's mata as to Shruti balad vachah eva iti purvapaksha. The vak completely resolves into manas. This is only because vak is not the karya of manas, and Purvapakshi does not agree that the laya should be only in its upadana karana. Karya can resolve anywhere. As per the Shruti, he says that let the resolution be of the vagindriya itself completely into manas. However, the Siddhanti disagrees. He says it is not the Vagindriya, it is only Vak Vritti that resolves into Manas, because that's what we see in the Loka as we saw in the Sutra Artha. So Siddhantastu Uktir Vak iti Bhava Vyutpatya Vak Chabdena Vak Vritti hi Uchyate. Vak is not Indriya. So what is the meaning of Vak? Purva Pakshi is taking it as Karne Vyutpatti. Siddhanti says that uktihi vak means what? With thin pratya, he is explained. Vachdhatu, when it takes thin pratya, because kiti samprasarana, samprasarana takes place, samprasarana is yan becomes ik, ikyanas samprasaranam. So vakara becomes ukara. The following akara goes away, and then that is samprasarana. Since the dhatu is vachdhatu, vach becomes uch. Then tin pratyaya will give uktihi, like bhakti, mukti, you will get ukti. So ukti and vak can have same meaning. based on what is the vyutpatti of vak. Vak has a different pratyaya, different krit pratyaya. Ukti is the meaning given for vak. Whenever you have to explain a bhave vyutpatti does not have a tinganta pada in the vigra vakya, vritti vakya. So derivation is not explained by the way you explain kartari or karmani or adhikarana vyutpatti. The ukti in is bhava vyutpatti. So vak ukti is explaining that it is bhava vyutpatti. What is bhava vyutpatti? Vak shabda. So vak here, vak manasi sampadyate, it is bhava vyutpatti, meaning it's shuddha dhatu artha. And what is a dhatu artha? Dhatu artha. Dhatu artha is just the speech, speaking. So speaking is the speech vritti. And thereby vak shabdena vak vritti hi uchyate, says the Siddhanti to Purva Pakshi. So bhava vyutpatti is there. There's a vak is by quip pratyaya. So quip pratyaya generally is kartari. So there can be an objection there as to quip pratyaya is only kartari. Vachi pachi chri through ghujvam dhirgo samprasaran cha is an unadi sutra. Unadi section is very difficult to see. But all of this is considered as krut. So although it is generally vak should be understood as kartari, however the meaning is karmani by krutya luto bahulam also. That's an ashtadhyayi sutra, it's not unadi sutra. So although kartari, sometimes you see in other meanings also in the meaning of lut, akartari cha karake sanyaya. Here it is bhave vyutpatti by unadi sutra also. You can understand that Kipratya is vachi swapi, that vach dhatu has taken by vachi, not vachi swapi, vachi pachi, pach maybe. So there are a multiple number of dhatus listed in a unadi sutra. There is dirgha, samprasarana, asamprasarana, or some kind of asamprasarana. There is not samprasarana, but dirgho asamprasaranam. So dirgha and asamprasarana. So vak does not take, although quip pratyaya is kit pratyaya, vach should have become uch, but it does not become because of unadi sutra derivation, not by ashtadhyayi sutra. And thereby vritti explains that vak meaning is uktihi, thereby it is bhave vyutpatti, it is shuddha dhatu artha, neither is it kartari nor is it karane, but it is bhavartha. So shuddha dhatu artha, which means vak vritti. Since it means vak vritti, then vritti resolves into mind. This is the meaning. Vag vritti uchyate, mano vritto satyameva manasi vag vrittihi liyate. And what does this say, this mano vritti? Vak manasi sampadyate, that is a connection here. Vak manasi sampadyate in that shruti, the mano vritti is still there, and while mano vritti is there, then itself vak vritti can resolve into the mind. So that's what is the meaning. Vak manasi sampadyate means manovritto satyameva, while you have a thought coming up in the mind but you don't speak, that time the vagvritti has resolved into the mind itself. It remains in the mind in a bija avastha. It is not manifest, it is avyakta. Like we see, you know, vaikhari is the manifestation. In tantra shastra we see vaikhari is the manifestation of the sound, but mantra etc. chanting can be done not only in vaikhari but up to, it can be done in para also, para pashyanti ityadi also, madhyama para pashyanti. So multiple levels are there. So similarly, you can understand that unmanifest speech is still in the mind. So this is the meaning in the resolution prakriya also, as to manovritto satyamyo manasi vak, vak vritti there. Vak vritti is a samasa, vachaha vritti, vak vritti hi, that is the meaning of vak, because it is bhavi vipatti. Liyate, there is laya. Kutaha, how so darshana? Since we see it, observe this, by anuhav also it is siddha, manovritto satyameva loke vagvritti layasya darshanat. We saw this example, so it should be clear. Tarhi, vakshabdasya kagatir ataha. Then what about this vakshabda? Shabda is there, it is shruti, sakshat shruti is there. So shabda cha tasya vakshabdasya vritti vrittimatoho abhedo upacharena bhava yutpatya va vag vritti paratvena nayanadityartha. So Siddhanti has already explained that bhava yutpatti is a possibility here. If Purva Pakshi does not agree, or he wants some other explanation, then Siddhanti says this vak shabda in the Shruti is an upachara to for vak vritti. So vritti and vritti mat is vak, and vritti is vak vritti. Between the vritti and vritti mat, there is no difference. The mind, mind itself converts into the vrittis. Thoughts are nothing but the mind itself manifesting in a subtle manner. It's a karya of the mind. So there is no difference, because we see hrir, dhir, bhir, all this is what? Manaha eva, says the Shruti. So similarly here, vritti and vritti mat. Vritti hi asya asti or asyam asti iti vritti mat. Asmin, not asyam asmin. Asya asmin va asti iti vritti mat. Matu pratyaya is added to vritti, so you get vritti mat. So between the vritti and vritti mat, what is the difference? Abheda. How? Upachara is done. There is an abheda, really karya karane ho abheda. Similarly, vritti and vrittiman also has abheda, and through that upachara, no, a secondary meaning has to be taken here, or bhava yutpatti, which has already been explained, thereby vag vritti paratvena. The vag shabda, vag manasi sampadyati, in that vag shabda is vag vritti para, meaning has the meaning of vag vritti, and thereby paratvena nayanad ityartha. You have to take the secondary meaning, and thereby you'll understand. Because primary meaning of vak, meaning vak indriya itself resolving into manas, is not right, because vak indriya is part of sukshma sharira. For a person who is dying, an ajnani who is dying, his vak indriya will continue. We'll see more in the other sutras. Ukta nyayam chakshuradishu atirishati. Similar is the interpretation needed, chakshu vritti ityadi, when the word chakshu, chakshu seems to be in the meaning of indriya in the laya prakriya. So the same explanation is extended to the other indriyas also. Ata evacha sarvanyanu. So Purvapakshi is told that sarvani anu, meaning chakshura indriya ni. So the only one padachya sarvani anu. Anu is anu paschat, following. So ata eva, and due to this very reason, ukta darshanad, since this observation is there in the world, therefore alone you have to see this meaning with each and every indriya in the sense of its secondary meaning, upachara, as to it means the indriya vritti. And that resolves into the shabda which has been mentioned by the Shruti, into the adhikarana that is mentioned by the Shruti. Sarvani, sarvani indriyani. It is atayevacha sarvani indriyani anu. Anu, anuvartante. You can say anuvartante, liyante. So similarly, as explained with darshan and shabda, the vritti is the meaning of each and every indriya wherever this laya prakriya is seen in such adhikarana, where there is no karya karana bhava. So that is sutra artha. Ata eva, meaning ukta darshanadi hetu. Darshanadi hetu means darsha, darshana and shabda. Because of observation in the world, anubhava siddha also, and shruti also says so. Therefore sarvani, sarvani meaning chakshuradi indriyanyapi, all the chakshur indriya ityadi also, savritti ke manasi, they resolve into the mind, where there is a vritti of this chakshur indriya works with chakshur vritti, where chakshur vritti is in the mind. So the mind has the vritti, then the indriya goes out to the, not then, but indriya, with the thought backing, it is seeing the, it is grasping the vishaya, whether it is seeing or whether it is tasting, etc. There is the vritti in the mind. That's why we say ghatakara vritti. Ghata indriya is sanyukta, it has sanyoga with the ghata, sanyukta with the ghata. And then ghata vritti is there. Similarly, when you are speaking about something, then there is a vritti in the mind. So that vritti resolves into the mind. That's what is the meaning in the case of each and every indriya. So vritti laya matrena anuvartante liyante. So the indriyas are still there, but they are said to have laya because their vrittis have resolved. Na swarupena ityartha. So swarupa laya is not there, indriyas are still there. For the dying person also, when the vrittis are going away are being resolved into the mind, still the indriyas are there. They may not be functioning well, but they are still there. Purvam manasi sarvendriya vritti laya ukta. The adhikarana is over. Manodhikaranam comes up with the introduction. Sorry. As to purvam manasi sarvendriya vritti laya ukta. Earlier, swarupalaya of the indriyas was rejected and the paksha of indriya vritti laya into the mind was accepted. That was established. Na tatha manasa prane vritti laya. Now, when the Shruti says, what does it say? Vang manasi sampadyate manah prane. So manah prane kim sampadyate as the anuvritti there. Manah prane sampadyate. Mind resolves into the in prana or attains prana. Samyak padyate. So there you cannot say that the manovritti has become prana, has resolved into prana, says the Purva Pakshi. Na tatha. So it's a counter example. Why so? Because Purva Pakshi quotes a Shruti. He says there is a Shruti, Anna Mayam hi Somya Mana Apo Mayav Pranaha Iti Shrutav Prana Manaso Abanna Vikaratva Shravanad Abanna Yoscha Upadana Upadeya Bhavat Swarupalaya Iti Pratyudharana Sangatya Idamaha. There is a counter example. Between Vak and Manas or Chakshuhu and Manas, there is no Karya Karana Sambandha. There is no upadana upadeya bhava. So upadana and upadeya bhava is material cause and the material effect. Material cause for pot is upadana, which is mrit clay. And the material effect of the clay, mrit, is ghataha, pot. So that kind of bhava, just give me a moment, there's an alarm ringing. So there is no such connection between the Chakshurindriya and the mind, or our example in the earlier sutra, the first sutra in this the earlier Adhikarana, as to Vak and Manas. So Vak and Manas or Chakshur and Manas or any Indriya and Manas do not have such kind of a sambandha. Now between Manas and Prana also there is no such sambandha. Prana is not upadana karana for Manas. However, Purva Pakshi says there is another sambandha. What is the sambandha? Karya karana sambandha is going to work out between, there is some sambandha he is going to show. What is he showing? He says, annamayam hi somya manahe somya. Annamayam hi manaha. Manas is what? Annamaya. And maya here is in karyartha. Vikarartha. Vikara meaning karya. So annamayam manaha. What does that mean? Mind is the vikar of anna. It is not the vikar of prana, but it is the vikar of anna. And what has been said? Manas will resolve into prana. If the Siddhanti were to ask, there is no karya karana sambandha, why should you not say vritti is going to resolve? Why do you say that there is a swarupalaya of the manas into prana? He says that apomaya prana is also shruti. Apomaya prana means jala karya is prana. So prana is the karya of jala and mana is the karya of anna. Manas is the karya of anna. And anna and apa, what is the difference? Jala, you consume jala, you consume anna also. Therefore he says prana manaso ho, between prana and manas, what is the sambandha now? Ab anna vikara. Ab is jala and anna. So jala and anna vikara respectively they are prana and manas. So vikaratva shravanad abannayoha cha upadana upadeya bhavat. And he says anna. What is anna? Anna is prithvi. In the chandogya prakriya, trivrutkarana prakriya, anna stands for prithvi also. Anna is Annamaya kosha, when you say it is, Annamaya means what? You don't see food. You see Prithvi Padartha there. So the Prithvi Karya is Annamaya kosha. That is an example. Here Annamaya does not mean kosha. Annamaya means vikar of Anna is Manas. So Manas is vikar of Prithvi and Prana is vikar of Jala. Prithvi is Jala Karya. In Trivrit Karanam also and in Panji Karanam also we see Prithvi is Jala Karya. So Prithvi being Jala Karya, there is Sambandha between the Karanas of Prana and Mana. What is the Mana and Prana do not have Karya Karana Bhava, but there is Karya Karana Bhava between the Upadana Karanas of Prana and Manas. Therefore, when there is Upadana Upadeya Bhava in the Karanas, he says, let there be such Karya Karana Bhava in their products, respective Karyas also. Thereby, he says, Prana Manasoho Avanna Vikaratva Shravanat. Since Prana and Manas are respectively what? Prana is Jala Karya, Ap Karya, and Manas is Anna Karya. Therefore, he says, Abhanayoho, between, and this is one part of the reasoning. Second part is what? Abhanayoscha, and also between Jala and Anna, Prithvi, there is Upadana Upadeya Bhava. So Upadana Upadeya Bhava Swarupalaya, there will be Swarupalaya because Karanas have Karya Karana Bhava. Between the Upadana Karanas, there is Upadana Upadeya Bhava. Thereby, their respective Karyas will also have Karya Karana Sambandha, Karya Karana Bhava. Sorry. Therefore, the Laya is now, as per the Laukika Nyaya, it is possible. He says that there is possibility of Manas to have Swarupalaya into Prana. Thereby, he gives a counter example, and Mano Adhikaranam has its first sutra as Tanmanah Prana Uttarat. Tanmanah Prana Uttarat. So Purva Pakshi objects, or rather presents, that the laya of Manas into Prana is Swarupalaya, not Vrittilaya only. To that, the Siddhanti answers that Tanmanah, that Tat Manah Prane Uttarat, Prane. So Tat Manah Prane Uttarat means what? Now Uttarat means what follows. But what is the Anuvritti is of this Vang Manasi Ityadi had Vang Manasi Sampadyate. Similarly, Sampadyate how? Vritti, Vrittilayena Sampadyate. Similarly here, Atayevacha Sarvani Indriyani Anuvartante or Anuliyante. Similarly, here also in third sutra, tat manas is neuter. It is a napumsakalinga shabda. Therefore, tat manaha kim prane sampadyate. Prane swavrutti layena eva sampadyate. Kutaha. What is the hetu there? So, uttarat. Because of the statement that follows. We'll see what this is further in the Uttarad Vakyad, you have to understand. We'll see in the Vritti further. But the Laya of the Manas into Prana is also not Swarupalaya, it is only Vrittilaya. And generally, what Purvapakshi is saying is not seen. What Purvapakshi is saying is, because the Karanas have Upadana Upadeya Bhava, does not mean that their respective Karyas will also have such Bhava. That is not possible. Swakarya Swakarana Karyayoho Upadana Upadayo Bhavaha Nasti Na Drishyate. Never is it seen. You don't see that, let's say there is a pot. With a pot you make something. What is an example? How would you explain this? So you have need a Karya Karana Bhava between the causes. So some just thinking, just give me a moment. Let's say you make something with a cloth. Let's say यू मेक समथिंग विथ अ क्लॉथ एंड क्लॉथ इज मेड विथ तंतु. विल दैट वर्क? ट्राइंग टू थिंक ऑफ एन एग्जाम्पल. Let me hold on to this. I am unable to think of an example because such thing is not. I have to think of a weird example because such thing is not seen. That's the reason the example doesn't come to mind because it is not observed. Purva Pakshi is making a claim that Swakarya, Swakarana Karyayoho, Swakarya and Swakarana Karyayoho, Upadana Upadeya Bhava is there. It is not there. So you'll have to imagine something like say clay is the cause for ghata. Huh? Let's take a simple example of clay. With clay you have created a pot and you have created let's say you have created with the clay you have created a pot or you have created set of let's say bricks. Okay, let's say you have created bricks with the clay. So between the clay and bricks there is a karya karana bhava. Upadana upadeya bhava. What is the cause for the bricks? They are clay bricks, therefore clay is the cause. So mrud and you have the ishtika. So you have the bricks and the clay. With them you have upadana upadeya bhava. Now assume that with the bricks you have constructed something. You have constructed a wall. And with the clay you have constructed, you have made a pot also. So now you have what? You have just like this, Anna and so Anna Karya. So we'll take up Jala and Anna. So Apakarya is Prana. So we'll say Ab is clay and Anna is its Karya. Therefore, clay Karya is brick. So with Anna, we'll have bricks. Now Prana is Apakarya. So Prana is Apakarya. So we'll take pot there. Prana is like pot there, Apakarya. And Anna Karya is Manas. So Anna Karya is Manas. We'll take the wall made by bricks as Manas. So now you have up Anna and Prana and Manas. Now because the bricks will resolve into clay, meaning Prithvi Anna will resolve into up, so should the Manas resolve into Prana in Swarupa, by Swarupa, said the Purva Pakshi. Now assume this, the bricks, will they resolve into clay? If you break, keep on breaking the bricks, then they'll become clay. All right. Because of this, does it mean that the karyas of the brick, which is the wall, will also resolve into the pot, which is the karya of the clay? So the moola karana clay, which was the karana for the bricks, and the brick karya is wall. And the clay karya is pot. So now is there a karya karana bhava between the pot and the wall? There is no such sambandha. If you break the wall, will it become a pot? It will not become a pot. How will it resolve into a pot? So this kind of a thing is not seen. That is the meaning here. Swarupalayati pratyudharana sangatya aha idamaha. Here Siddhanti is countering Purva Pakshi, saying that there is no darshana like that. So darshanad hetoho and Shruti Heto, Shabdacha will not work there at all. You'll have to give me an example. Where in the world have you seen? Shruti says so. Just because Shruti says so, you cannot say that it is so, because we can understand the Shruti in a different manner also, as to Vritti Laya takes place, just like in the case of Indriyas resolving into the Antakkarana, mind. So Tanmanah Prane Uttarat. Uttarat, the Uttara Vakya says so. Phalam Purovat. So the argument is the same as it was in the case of the Chakshuradi Indriya, or before that Vag Manasi Sampadyate, there in the Vag Indriya case also. Manav Prane Iti Uttara Vakye. So Manav Prane Iti Uttara Vakye Kim Manasah Prane Swarupalaya Vritti Layova Iti Samshaya. Whether there is complete Antakkarana Laya into Prana by Swarupa, or only the Manovritti resolves into Prana, when such doubt comes up, Swarupalayati Purva Paksha. We saw that Purva Pakshi is claiming that the manas will completely resolve into its non-karana prana via their own respective karanas having upadana upadeya bhava. Siddhantastu tat sarve tat means tat manas. सर्वेंद्रिय वृत्ति लय आधारम, दिस मनस इज दी आधारा फॉर दी लय ऑफ ऑल इंद्रियास, दैट मनस मन अपि प्राणे स्ववृत्ति लयेनेव लीयते। दी वृत्तिज चक्षुरेन्द्रिय काइंड ऑफ वृत्ति और रसनेन्द्रिय काइंड ऑफ वृत्तिज और वागेन्द्रिय काइंड ऑफ वृत्तिज विच हैव हैड लया इन दी मनस, दैट आधारा मनस ऑल्सो हैज इट्स ओन वृत्तिज विच विल रिजॉल्व इन टू प्राण। स्ववृत्ति लयेनेव लीयते न स्वरूपेण, न तो स्वरूपेण, स्वरूप लय इज नॉट देयर, मनस स्टिल कंटिन्यूज जस्ट लाइक इंद्रियाज कंटिन्यू। इमेजिन दिस इंद्रियाज हैव ऑलरेडी बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड टू कंटिन्यू, व्हाट विल हैपन इफ द माइंड इटसेल्फ रिजॉल्व्स कंप्लीटली? दैट इज इलॉजिकल एज वेल। द माइंड कैन नॉट रिजॉल्व एज लॉन्ग एज इंद्रियाज आर देयर। इंद्रियाज आर देयर इन स्वरूप, ओनली वृत्ति लय इज देयर। सिमिलरली द माइंड विल ऑल्सो कंटिन्यू टू बी देयर, वृत्ति लय विल बी देयर। सो मन प्राणे इति उत्तराद वाक्याद अवगंतव्यम। So Uttarat is not a hetu here. I was thinking how to establish this hetu. I thought the vritti will unfold that. So there is no hetu. Hetu has already been given earlier, and we saw illogicality also. And Purvapakshi does not have any hetu to establish this. There is no darshana hetu. Shruti hetu has already been explained. Therefore, Uttarat vakyat avagantavyam. That's all it is. From the so Purvapakshi is saying Uttarat vakyat hetu he can claim. Siddhanti can say that Uttarat vakyat. If it is read as hetu, we have to say uttarad vakyat just like shabdat. So uttarad vakyat uttarad shabdat. So shabdat has already been established as hetu. The same hetu can be continued by saying uttarad shabdat hetu, uttarad hetu ho shabdat. Or you can take it as plain vanilla uttarad vakyat avagantavyam, as the vritti says, meaning there is no separate reasoning needed. From the later vakya, what the Purvapakshi claims, for that he has no explanation possible logically, or there is no practicality at all. However, Siddhanti says that with the explanation that we have given in the earlier two sutras, the same holds here as well. And what hetu or what reasoning Purvapakshi had given for that, we have seen the answer with the example of the clay and its product brick and their respective products, as to pot and the wall. So we see that the wall does not resolve into the pot. Now thereby uttarad vakyad avagantavyam. Supti mrityavasthayoho savrittike prane satyeva manovritti laya darshanaditi hetvanushanga. So what the hetu was given in the earlier sutras as to darshana, that hetu continues here as to what supti mruti avastayo, in the sushupti avastha and the marana avastha, savritti ke prane sati eva manovritti laya darshanad iti hetu anushanga. So using the sushupti and the mrityu example, we can understand anubhava siddha. In sushupti and marana, just like in this section we are discussing the laya of Indriyas and Manas of the Upasaka as well as Jnani. That is a context really. So Marana and in Sushupti we have an Anubhava, and in Marana we have to learn from, you know, what others say about Marana. Not dying person, but having seen the dying person or learning from Shastra. So Supti मृत्यवस्थयोः सवृत्तिके प्राणे, द प्राणा स्टिल कंटिन्यूज वाइल द पर्सन इज डाइंग, नॉट डेड बट वाइल डाइंग, दैट टाइम इंद्रियाज आर स्टिल देयर, बिकॉज इवन इफ यू सी द पर्सन इज नॉट टॉकिंग, इज ट्राइंग टू टॉक। सती एव मनोवृत्ति लय दर्शनाद इति हेत्वानुषंग। सो मनोवृत्ति कंटिन्यूज, सॉरी मनोवृत्ति रिजॉल्व्स इन टू प्राण, बट प्राण कंटिन्यूज एंड मनस ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूज। दिस इज द हेतु दर्शनाद हेतु अनुषंगा, दैट शुड बी ब्रॉट डाउन हियर फ्रॉम द अर्लियर सूत्र द हेतु। नहि अवन्नयो उपादान उपादेयत्व मात्रेण तद्विकारयो उपादान उपादेय भावः युक्तः। सो देयर इज नो सच कनेक्शन बिटवीन द कार्यास, बिकॉज देयर ओन स्वकारणास हैव उपादान उपादेय भाव। जस्ट बिकॉज देयर इज उपादान एंड उपादेय भाव बिटवीन स्वकारणास ऑफ टू थिंग्स, डज नॉट एक्सटेंड द उपादान उपादेय भाव टू दि कार्याज ऑल्सो, इट डज नॉट एक्सटेंड। युक्त वी सॉ द एग्जाम्पल, हियर द एग्जाम्पल इज देयर। सो हिमघटयो तद अदर्शनाद इति भाव। So there is a good example with the Jala and Prithvi itself. For some reason I forgot this. I didn't look up also right now. So Hima Ghatayoh. So you look up this between Jala and Prithvi, there is Upadana Upadeya Bhava, up and Anna, as given by the Purva Pakshi. Okay, we agree. Yes, there is Upadana Upadeya Bhava. But what about the Jala Karya Hima? Ice, you take ice is the Jala Karya. What about Ghata? Ghata is Anna Karya, Mrit Karya, Prithvi Karya. So just because there is Karya Karana Bhava between Mrit, Jala and Prithvi, does it mean that the Ghata will resolve in ice? It will not. So Hima and Ghata, there is no such Upadana Upadeya Bhava. Their Karanas have Upadana Upadeya Bhava. Just because of that, you cannot say that the Karyas will also have Upadana Upadeya Bhava. Tad Adarshanat. It is not seen that Ghata, we don't see Ghata resolving into ice. You don't see the pot. If you break the pot, it does not become ice. Iti Bhava, so it is very ridiculous. We'll stop here, we'll continue in the next part. Amnayante Samsiddham Adhimadhyanta Varjitam Arandaghanam Apurnam Atma Jyotir Upasmahe. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Namaste.